Now we will do the sums based on the complementary angle. So, first sum when we consider, it is tan 10, tan 10 degree, tan 15 degree, tan 75 degree, tan 80 degree. So, it's all product of tan. Tan 10, tan 15, tan 75, tan 80. So, when you have same trigonometric function, we group it which makes complementary. That is, the sum of two angles should be 90 degree. So, I can see now tan 10 and tan 80, I will group it. Tan 10 and tan 80, I will group it so that we get 10 plus 80, 90 degree. Next, tan 15 and tan 75. So, 15 and 75 gives us 90 degree. So, when we have more than 2-3 terms of trigonometric function, we group the complementary angles, which two angles when you add, you get 90 degree. So, here we can see 10 plus 80, 90. So, we group 15 and 75, 90, we group. Now, tan 10, tan 80 as tan of 90 minus 10. So, tan 10, 80 I can write 90 minus 10. Next, then I have tan 15. Tan 75 can be written as tan of 90 minus 15. Now, this you can rewrite tan 10. Tan of 90 minus theta is cot theta. So, this will become cot 10. Then, next part is tan 15. Tan of 90 minus 15. Tan of 90 minus theta is cot theta. Cot 15. Next step, tan 10. Cot is reciprocal of tan, no? So, 1 by tan 10. Then, this tan 15. Then, cot 15 is reciprocal of tan. So, I can write tan 15. You can see now tan 10 get cancelled. Tan 15, tan 10 get cancelled. Finally, we have 1 as our solution. This is our answer. I'll repeat. They have given you with the trigonometric tan 4 terms. We group which makes complementary 90 degree. So, 10 and 80 makes us 90. We group it. 15 and 75 gives us 90. So, we group it. Then, we rewrite bigger angle in terms of smaller angle, difference of complementary. Tan 10, tan 80 can be written in terms of smaller angle, 90 minus 10. So, that 90 minus 10, tan of 90 minus theta is cot theta. So, I will get cot 10. Cot can be rewritten as reciprocal of tan. So, it get cancelled. Similarly, the other part, tan 15 and tan 75 can be written in terms of smallest angle, tan of 90 minus 15, which is cot 15. Tan of 90 minus theta, cot theta, reciprocal of tan. Tan and tan get cancelled. So, you can see all trigonometric function got cancelled. Our solution is 1. Okay. So, now, second sum we will try. The second sum is sine 42, secant 48. Sine 42, secant 48 plus cos 42, cosecant 48. We have to find sine 42, secant 48, cos 42, cosecant 48. Here, they itself grouped it, 42 and 48, 90. 42 and 48, they have grouped it and you have in between plus sign. So, now what we do, the bigger angle, we try to write in terms of smaller angle. So, I get sine 42. Secant can be written as 90 minus, if not, 90 minus 42 gives us 48 plus cos 42. Cosecant 48 can be written as cosecant of 90 minus 42. 90 minus 42. Cosecant 90 minus 42, 48. This we can write sine 42 into secant of 90 minus 42 is what? Secant of 90 minus theta is cosecant theta. So, I have cosecant 42 plus cos 42. Cosecant of 90 minus 42 is secant 42. Cosecant of 90 minus theta, secant theta. This we can rewrite sine 42. Cosecant is reciprocal of sine. Plus cos 42, secant is reciprocal of cos. So that it get cancelled 1 plus here it get cancelled 1. So we have our answer 2. Again I'll repeat. We have sine 42 secant 48 plus cos 42 cosecant 48. So we try to write that bigger angle in terms of smaller angle where we have grouped it to complementary. So 42 and 48 gives us 90. So this 48 is bigger. So we write 48 as 90 minus 42. So that you get sine 42. Secant of 90 minus theta is cosecant theta, cosecant 42. Cosecant is reciprocal of sine. So it get cancelled 1. Similarly, other next part, cos 42. Cosecant 48, we can write cosecant of 90 minus 42, which is cosecant of 90 minus theta, secant theta. So cos 42, secant is 1 by cos. Cos and cos get cancelled 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. So the answer is 2 here. Sum. Sine 2 divided by 64 plus cos 26 divided by cosecant 64. So same way, here you can check 26 and 64 give complementary angle, 26 and 64 gives us complementary angle. So we try to write the bigger angle in terms of smaller angle. So I can write sine 26 divided by secant of 64, I can write as 90 minus 26 plus cos 26 cosecant of 90 minus 26. Cosecant 90 minus 26 is 64. This we can rewrite. Sine 26, secant of 90 minus theta is what? Cosecant theta, cosecant 26 plus cos 26, cosecant of 90 minus 26 is secant 26. This we can rewrite. Sine 26, cosecant is what? 1 by sine 26 plus cos 26, 1 by cos 26. When you make it reciprocal, the numerator becomes sine 26 into sine 26 plus cos 26 into cos 26, which we get it as sine square 26 plus cos square 26. Sine square theta plus cos square theta identity is 1. This is your solution. I'll repeat. Question is sine 26 by secant 64 plus cos 26 cosecant 64. So, we will check first the given angles are complementary. Yes, 26 and 64 gives us 90. 26 and 64 gives us 90. Then we try to write bigger angle in terms of smallest angle. So, bigger angle here is 64. So, secant 64 can be written 90 minus 26. Same way in the second part, cos 26 divided by 64. Cosecant 64 can be written as cosecant of 90 minus 26. Now we know by complementary angle formula, secant of 90 minus theta is cosecant theta. So cosecant 26, cosecant of 90 minus theta is secant theta, secant 26. Now sine 26, cosecant is reciprocal of sine, so 1 by sine, plus cos divided by secant, secant can be written as reciprocal of cos. When we simplify, this 26 will go to the numerator other side, sine 26 into sine 26 plus cos 26 into cos 26, which is sine square 26 plus cos square 26. So you know the identity, sine square plus cos square is 1. So we write the solution it as 1. Now, express each of the following terms of angles between 0 and 45. So the question is sine 59 plus tan 63. So sine 59. How can we write sine 59? Sine 59 can be written as sine of 90 minus. In 59, how much it will go? You can tell me. 90 minus, is it not how much? 31? 90 minus 31 is 59. See, subtract, it's a normal subtraction. 90 minus 31, it goes 9. This will become 8. 8 minus 3, 59. Plus tan of 63, 90 minus. So with what when you subtract you get 63? I will have 27. 90 minus 27 gives you 63. So, in this sum, again I'll repeat, 59 can be rewritten with the smallest angle, 90 minus 31, the complementary angle with 90, what we subtract to get 59, 90 minus 31, 63, 90 minus 27. Sine of 90 minus theta is what? Cos theta, so cos 31 degree. Tan of 90 minus 27, tan of 90 minus theta, cot 27. So, there, the given question, which is greater than 49 degree, 45 degree, we have reduced it to the angle 0 to 45. Cos 31 and cot 27 lies between 0 to 45. We have simplified. So, the given question, whatever they have given the number, we try to write it as complementary angle. With 90 degree, what you subtract to get the given angle, you will subtract. And use the complementary formula, 90 minus theta formula, and substitute and get the answer. So that in the answer, you can see the values lies between 0 and 45, what they have asked for us. Now, similar way, we have two more sums. Cosecant 68 and cot 72, which we have to write between the angle 0 and 45. Cosecant 68, how can we write in terms of complementary angle? Cosecant of 90 minus, with what you can subtract to get 68? 90 minus 22. So you can see, subtract and say you get 68 degree. Plus cot of complementary angle of 72, 90 minus 18. 90 minus 18 gives you 72. Now, cosecant of 90 minus 22. Cosecant of 90 minus theta is secant theta. Cot of 90 minus 18 is tan theta. So, we have rewritten the angles on the bigger side to the angles which lies between 0 to 45. Next, cos 74 plus secant 77. So, 74, how can you write in complementary? 90 minus 16 plus secant 67. 67 can be written as 90 minus 23. We are rewriting the bigger angle in terms of smaller angle using complementary. So, cos of 90 minus theta is sine theta, sine 16. Secant of 90 minus 23. Secant of 90 minus theta is cosecant theta, cosecant 23. So, the bigger angle are rewritten with the trigonometric function which lies between 0 to 45. This is what they have asked you to do the sum. Express each of the following terms of angles between 0 and 45, where the question is given with the higher angles more than 45. We try to write that bigger angle as complementary angle in terms of 90 minus what, and we use our complementary angle formula, sine of 90 minus theta, cos of 90 minus theta, sine theta, and we complete the answer and we write all the angles to the angles which lies between 0 to 45. Next sum, evaluate sine 35 into cos 45 plus cos 35 into sine 55 divided by cosecant square 10 minus tan square 80. This sum they have asked you in the year 2010, and there are a few years also they have asked. So for you now, this is one important sum because it has been asked in your board exam. So how we will do? So same way we check here, they have given 55 and 35 complementary, 90. 35 plus 55, 90. So we write bigger angle in terms of smaller angle. So I write sine 35, cos 55, can I write 90 minus 35? 90 minus 35 gives you 55 plus cos 35, sine of 55, sine of 90 minus 35. Cos 35, sine 55 again, 90 minus 35 divided by, you have now cosecant square, here 10 and 80 gives you 90 degree, no? So, I can write cosecant square 10 minus tan squared 80, I can write as 90 minus 10. So, that 90 bigger angle, I'll write in terms of complementary, 90 minus 10, we will get 80. So, I have now sine 35. Cos of 90 minus 35, cos of 90 minus theta, sine theta, plus cos 35, sine of 90 minus theta is cos theta, cos 35, divided by cosecant square 10 minus tan squared 90 minus 10. Tan of 90 minus 10 is cot theta. So this will become cot squared 10. Here, sine 35 into sine 35 is sine squared 35. Cos 35 into cos 35 is cos squared 35 divided by, you know by our identity, cos squared theta minus cot squared theta is equal to 1. So, numerator also 1, denominator also 1. So, final answer is for us 1. So, the solution is 1. I'll repeat. Evaluate sine 35 cos 55 plus cos 35 sine 55 divided by cosecant squared 10 minus tan squared 80. So, we can check first given angles are making complementary or not. So, in the first term 35 and 55 makes 90. 35 and 55 makes 90. 10 and 80 makes 90. Okay. Next, we write the bigger angle in terms of smaller angle. So, sine 35 cos 55. Bigger angle I can write 90 minus 35 plus cos 35 sine 55. 55 again I can write as the smaller angle 90 minus 35. Cosecant squared 10 minus tan squared 80 can be written as 90 minus 10. Now use your formulas. Sine 35 cos of 90 minus theta sine theta plus cos 35 sine of 90 minus theta cos theta. This is cosecant squared 10 minus tan of 90 minus theta cot theta. So it will become cot squared. You know by identity sine squared plus cos squared is 1. Cosecant squared minus cot squared is 1. 1 by 1, which is 1 for you. Next sum, we have to prove cos of 90 minus theta into cos theta divided by cot theta is 1 minus cos squared. We have to prove. So, when we take LHS, cos of 90 minus theta, how can you write? Sin theta into cos theta divided by cot theta. Cot theta, can I rewrite as cot is cos by sin? So, which comes here as a reciprocal? Sin by cos. So, cos and cos get cancelled. We have sin squared theta. Where sin squared theta you can rewrite as 1 minus cos squared theta. I'll repeat for you. Question is cos of 90 minus theta into cos theta divided by cot theta is 1 minus cos squared theta. We know in LHS cos of 90 minus theta is sin theta multiplied by the given cos theta divided by cot. Cot is what cos by sin. Will come other side as reciprocal sine by cos. So cos and cos get cancelled. Sine theta into sine theta is sine squared. Sine squared we can rewrite as 1 minus cos squared using our identity. That is the proof. Similarly, sine theta into sine of 90 minus theta divided by cot of 90 minus theta is equal to 1 minus sine squared theta we have to prove. So when you take LHS, I get sin theta, sin of 90 minus theta is cos theta divided by tan, cot of 90 minus theta is tan theta. Now, sin theta into cos theta, tan is what sin by cos. When it comes to other side, it will become cos by sin. Sin and sin get cancelled. You have cos squared theta, which we can write as 1 minus sin squared theta. That is what we should prove. I'll repeat now. Sin theta into sin of 90 minus theta divided by cot of 90 minus theta is 1 minus sin squared theta. So, sin theta, sin of 90 minus is cos theta divided by cot of 90 minus is tan theta is equal to sin into cos. Tan is what? Cos by sin. Will be gone other side. Tan is sin by cos. When you take it to other side, it will become cos by sin. Sin and sin get cancelled. Cos theta into cos theta is cos squared theta. Cos squared theta we can rewrite as 1 minus sin squared theta. So we have proved now lot of using our identities and we did the combination of complementary angle identity everything. So for all the sums we have done, once again, you redo all the sums once in assignment notebook and do the Selina from the textbook, page 328, question number 3. two subdivisions are there, and the examples 9 and 10, the same page number. From that you can write question number 3, two subdivisions, and examples 9 and 10. So in tomorrow's class, we will do more with this complementary sums, and we will complete the complementary formulas tomorrow.